Okay, so are you ready to start? Yes, sir. Okay, so let's start our 2 days class. As you say that we'll start from question number five. Okay, so let's draw the diagram given in the question number five. So look, in the given figure, the arms of two angles are parallel. If angle ABC is equal to 70 degree, then find these two values. Okay, so first draw two angles. One is this angle. And one is suppose this angle. The arms of the angles are parallel to each other. Means this angle and this angle are parallel to each other. And also these two arms, these arms and this arm are parallel to each other. Okay, so name of the angle is given ABC and DEF. This is our ABC angle. And this is our DEF angle. And the point, this point is Z. This point is Z. And one angle is given. This angle is 70 degree. So two questions are given. What is the value of angle DGC? So on the diagram, DGC. So what is the value of the angle DGC? And the second question is, what is the value of the angle DEF? What is the value of this angle? Okay, clear? Okay, so let's now solve it. Try to solve it. Okay, now it is given that this line and this line are parallel to each other, and BC is the transversal. One second. Okay, so this angle is given as 70 degree. So we have to find what is the measurement of this angle. Now look, here AB and DE are two parallel line, and BC is the transversal. So we know that these two angles are called the corresponding angles. One interior angle and one exterior angle on the same side of the transversal. So this angle is called the corresponding angles. Okay, this angle is called, these two angles are called corresponding angles. So write here angle, look, angle DGC is equal to angle ABC. Why they're equal? Because they are corresponding angle. Because they are corresponding angles. That means angle DGC is equal to 70 degree. So what is the measurement of the angle DGC? This is 70 degree. Okay? Now we'll calculate the value of DEF, means this angle. Okay, now look, here also BC and EF are two parallel line, and DE is the transversal. So there is a relationship between this angle and this angle. Look, that one is the interior angle and one is the exterior angle on the same side of transversal. So they are also corresponding angles. Also, angle DEF is equal to angle DGC. Why? Because they are also corresponding angles. That means angle DEF is equal to 70 degree. So this angle is also 70 degree. So this is 70 degree and this is also 70 degree. Complete it. Okay, so tell me, have you understood? Have you understood? Okay. Now let's then go to the next question. Question number 6. Okay. There are 4 questions. I will solve 2 or 3 questions, and one or two questions will be for you. I left it for you. Okay. So read the question once. So the question is given here that in the given figure below, decide whether the line L and the line M are parallel to each other, are parallel. Okay. So first draw the diagram. 2 line L and M are given. One is the line L and one is the line M. And one transversal is also here. We have to check whether the lines are parallel to each other. And it is given that this angle is 44 degree. And this angle is given as 126 degree. Okay, this is A line, this is M line, and this is N line. We have to check the lines are parallel to each other or not. Okay, so first give it a name. Let this is our AB point. This is the CD line. And this is the EF line. And the point where they intersect are P and Q. Now look at the angle BPQ, angle BPQ and the angle PQD. What type of angle there? They are actually the interior angle lying on the same side of the transversal, means actually co-interior angle. So we know that if the lines are parallel to each other, so sum of the co-interior angle must be equal to 180 degree. Conversely, if the sum of the co-interior angle is equal to 180 degree, then we can say that the lines are parallel to each other. Otherwise, they are not parallel. Okay. So here, we'll check whether the sum of the co-interior angle is equal to 180 degree or not. Okay. So this is a 7-1. Here, angle BPQ plus angle PQD is equal to 126 degree plus 44 degree. So if I add them, so the result will be 170 degree. Yes. Now as the sum of the co-interior angle. They are the co-interior angle now. So co-interior angle is not equal to 180 degree. Therefore, the line L and M are not parallel. So the line L and M are not parallel. If the sum of the co-interior angle is equal to 180 degree, then you can say the lines are parallel to each other. Otherwise, not. Okay. So as here, the sum of the co-interior angle is 170, not 180, so the lines are not parallel. Understood? Students, have you understood? Yes. Okay. Now, let's go to the next question. Question number 2 of 7. Question number 2. So, diagram is given. 2 lines are here. One line is like this. One line is like this. And one transversal is here. We have to check the lines are parallel to each other or not. This line is L, this line is M, and this line is N. And one two angle is given. This angle is 75 degree and also this angle is 75 degree. Now we have to check whether the line L and the line M are parallel to each other or not. Okay, someone's Shobhik Sharma, please mute your mic. I'm muting you once. Okay, so let's give it a name. Let the name of this line is AB. Name of this line is CD. Name of this line is EF. And this is the P point and this is the Q point. Okay. Now, tell me one thing. Can you find any relationship between this angle and this angle? Tell me, if there are any relationship, then what is this? They are vertical opposite angle. Very good. They are vertical opposite angle. And we know that the vertically opposite angles are equal to each other. So right here, angle APQ. APQ. Look at the APQ, mean this angle is equal to this angle APB, is equal to angle EPB. Why they're equal? We'll write the reason, because they are vertical opposite angle. Vertically opposite angle. That means angle APQ is equal to 75 degree. This is 75 degree, so this angle is also 75 degree. Okay, now look, this angle and this angle APQ and CQP, see, this angle and this angle are the interior angle on the same side of the transversal, means they are co-interior angle. So if their sum is equal to 180 degree, so the line will be parallel. Otherwise, it will not be parallel line. Okay. So now, find out what is the sum of these two angles. Means angle APQ. APQ plus angle CQP. CQP. Look at the diagram. APQ and CQP. That is equal to 75 degree plus 75 degree. That is equal to 150 degree. Since the sum of the co-interior angle is not equal to 180 degree, so the lines are not parallel to each other, right? As the sum of co-interior angle is not equal to 180 degree, therefore the line L and the line M are not parallel. Therefore, the line L and the line M are not parallel to each other. Okay? Did you understand? Yes, okay. So now we can move to the next question. Question number 3. Okay. So let's draw the diagram and I am rubbing the board. Question number 3. So the diagram is given here. Draw the diagram. This is the first line. This is another line and one transversal. The name of this line is L. The name of this line is M. And this line is N. This angle is 123 degree. and this angle is 57 degree. We have to check whether the line L and the line M are parallel to each other or not. Yes, they will be parallel. Very good. Okay, so let's give it a name. Let this is our AB line. This is CD line. This is EF line. And these two points are P and Q. Okay. Now look, there is a relationship between this angle and this angle. This angle and this angle. Okay, look, here the line AB and the line EF intersect each other at the point P. So these two angles are vertically opposite angles, and the vertically opposite angle will be always equal to each other. So this angle will be 57 degree. Okay, so right, here angle APQ is equal to angle EPB. Angle APQ is equal to angle EPB. Why? Because they are vertical opposite angle. Vertically opposite angle. Because they are vertically opposite angle. That means angle APQ is equal to 57 degree. So this angle is 57 degree. Now look at these two angles. Angle APQ and CQP. They are the co-interior angle. Interior angle on the same side of the transversal. So we'll add up these two angles. Now find the result when you add up these two angles. Angle APQ and angle PQC. So this result will be 57 degree plus 123 degree. So if I add 57 and 123, so what will be the result? Result will be 180 degree. Now look here, the sum of the co-interior angle is equal to 180 degree. As the sum of the co-interior angle is equal to 180 degree, therefore the line L and the line M are parallel to each other. Parallel. The line L and the line M are parallel. Okay, any problem you have? Any problem from your side? No problem. Okay, what happened if I leave the last question, question number 4 for you? Can you solve it by yourself? Yes, that's the spirit. Yes, I know you can solve it yourself. Okay, so I'm not doing the last question, question number 4. Okay, very good. Okay, and so this exercise 5.2 is also completed now. Not only the exercise, I think the whole chapter is completed. Lines and angles is completed. So next day, we'll start a new chapter, that is the triangle and its properties. Clear? Okay. So, up to my next class. Bye-bye. Thank you so much.